Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I'll be teaching you Python. As you guys know, that as the title says, it is a Python tutorial. So today the first lecture. So one thing I'll let you all know that Python is a pretty simple to learn language, and I'm here to make it much more simpler for you. So before starting with the code, I'd like to let you guys know the demand, the growth, and the applications of this simple yet powerful language. So I'll just let you know the growth, because as you can see on this graph here, the growth trajectory of Python is pretty exponential as compared to other languages. Either all the other languages are equally valuable in current the market scenario, Python is the most in demand and emerging language. So I would it will be a great pleasure it will be a pleasure to teach you guys Python. So let's move forward. If you just type Python growth on Google, and you can see that every next blog is mentioning that it is that Python is a very quickly growing language. So I think this should motivate you enough to push yourself and start learning, and of course I'm here to help you. Third thing is the applications. Python is used for web applications, mostly web backend web applications, and the most in demand career right now is data science. So I'll like to give you a brief overview of all this. So that Django is a big complete major framework specifically for web development. So you can, if you know Python, you can learn Django, and currently Django is a Django web developers are very much in demand, so I guess you should definitely learn. And second thing is Flask. Flask is kind of a micro framework for even it this uses Python, and Python and Flask and Django web developers are very much in demand. Third thing is data science, which is touted as the sexiest job of 21st century. So I guess this should definitely motivate you to learn Python. Data science is basically a combination of mathematics, statistics, deep learning, artificial intelligence, machine learning, and data analytics. You can either use Python or R, but since Python can be used for web development as well, creating web APIs, RESTful APIs, and many other applications, I guess Python is a preferred language currently for major developers. So now I'll just give you a download link for Python. You can download Python from this particular website. I'll mention the link below. You can just go to this website and download the Python version, but there are various versions ranging from 2.7 to 3.7. But I will highly recommend that you guys download the version 3.6, because there are many reasons, which is not the topic right now, but I will recommend that you guys download the version 3.6. So according to your Windows version, whichever you're using Windows 64-bit or 32-bit, so according to that, I will recommend that you guys download the specific Python version. As you can see here, this is there are various versions for Mac, Windows, Linux. So yeah, in case if you do not know which version your computer is, so I will just go on my computer and right click on properties. Yeah, you can see that my computer is a 64-bit operating system. It is a 64-bit one, so I will download the 64-bit version of Python. And I'll recommend that you guys download the executable installer. This one, the Windows x86 64 executable installer. You just have to double click on this installed downloaded file, and it will start installation. So I already downloaded the Python I already downloaded the Python, so I will directly go to that part now. Now as you can see, I have two versions here, 3.5 and 3.6, but I will recommend that you guys download and install the 3.6 version. The installation is pretty simple. You just have to double click here and it will show a pop up something like this. So instead of directly going to install now, I will I want you guys to just select this add Python 3.6 to path. This is a very important step if you want to avoid many answers which may arise after later on, but I will recommend that you select this tick mark and later on go to install now, and you can keep on clicking next until the Python version gets completely installed. And once it is installed, you guys should check whether it is to check if it is properly installed or not. Just launch cmd or PowerShell, whichever you prefer. Uith python -- v version. I am using 3.5, so it is showing 3.5, and in case if you have downloaded 3.6, then it will show up 3.6 in your system. Okay, so this shows that Python is properly downloaded, and now I will just give you a small brief coding experience since you downloaded Python, and I would like to you guys to see some coding as well. So basic coding examples here, just basic algebraic coding examples here. Let's type in some mathematical operations like 3 + 5. As expected, it is 8. 10 minus 3, which gives you 7. As expected, it was a subtraction operation. Now let's multiply something. 16 multiplied by 6, it should give you 96. Yeah, as expected. Now let's divide something as 80 divided by 6. It gives me a decimal point. Like value 13.33333 up. Okay, so in case if you want only the integer value and without the decimal, there may be many applications and operations in Python which in which you will want the immediate integer value instead of a floating value. So what you can do is I'll use the same value 80 divided by 6, but you need to use two division signs in order to obtain only the integer value. That will give you a 13 as the answer. Yes, it gives you 13. Now let's do square root, but before doing square root, let's do a square of something, power of something. In power, as in, you guys may be definitely be aware of power, something raised to something. Let me give an example. 2 raised to 2. 2 multiplication sign after integer gives you the power. So 2 to the power 2 gives you 4. Now let's do 2 to the power 4, 16. Now I guess you guys understand what this means. Now let's do a square root operation. 36. Let's take 36, which should give you an expected output of 6. SQRT 36. It throws me an error. Oh, yeah, this is because I haven't imported the square root library. Import math library, which is very you don't need to write many lines of code to obtain the square root. So there are many libraries in Python which are already coded. There are many libraries which are available which will help you to save your time and coding various stuff. So let's just import from math import sqrt. Okay, so I think there won't be an error now. SQRT 36. It should give me a 6. As expected, it gives me a 6. So I guess this was the basics of Python, and I hope you like this video. See you in the next video. Thank you.